Jesus. We thank you for the word that is coming forth tonight, Lord. Let it minister to every soul, to every listener in the name of Jesus. Thank you for granting us understanding, Holy Spirit of God. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, receive glory and praise. Receive our adoration. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's have our seats in the presence of the Lord. Amen. I want us to welcome everyone who's viewing us online. The Lord bless you for tuning in. And everyone who's in the service this evening, we thank God for bringing you here today in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So today we're learning about financial stewardship and how serving God teaches you, and even what it has taught me about financial stewardship. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
I hope you have your Bibles ready, your notebooks ready, and ready to hear from heaven. Amen. 1 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 2. So how is serving God and finances related? Praise the Lord. Serving God is all about stewardship. Amen? Serving God is all about stewardship. 1 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 2. The Bible says, moreover, it is required in stewards that a man be found faithful. Amen? Moreover, it is required in stewards that a man be found faithful. Hallelujah. So a servant is first and foremost a steward. In fact, that's the other name of a servant, a steward. Praise the Lord. A steward. Amen. And who's a steward? Who is a steward? Is someone who has been entrusted with something. Entrusted with something. Glory to God. So when we're talking about finances, it's God has entrusted us with finances, amen? There's nothing that you have that you have not received, amen? Even the money that you have, there's nothing that you have that you have not received. So we have been entrusted with something. Steward is someone who has been entrusted with something. And being entrusted here, you can see the word trust, amen? You have been trusted to handle this thing. You have been trusted, is it maybe to... Mostly, a steward, you can, it's mostly defined as someone who manages an estate, as a manager of an estate. You know, whatever goes on in that estate, he is responsible. Amen? He is responsible. So a steward, number one, must be accountable. A steward or a servant is someone who must be accountable and responsible. And then as we have seen in 1 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 2, that as moral is quite as steward that a man be found faithful. Amen. Faithful, faithful. Meaning that someone has to be faithful, accountable, responsible, and faithful. Amen. And these are the, and I think, great attributes when it comes to our finances, our money, that we need to be accountable, we need to be responsible, we need to be faithful. Praise the Lord. We need to be faithful. Meaning we have to show it, not only in finances, but in every area as a servant of Jesus Christ. Amen. We need to be faithful. And I love what Paul is telling this Corinthians. And in verse 1, the Bible says, let a man so account of us as if he is placing himself under the scrutiny of the brethren. He's saying, account of us as ministers of Christ. Praise the Lord. And stewards of the mysteries of God. Praise the Lord. They were stewards of the mysteries of God. So they were, he knows they expected to be faithful. And he's telling someone, account me. Praise the Lord. Can you be accounted when it comes to money? Can you be accounted when it comes to money? Amen. Hallelujah. Are we together? Can you be accounted? Can you say, account, let a man so account of us. So account of us. He was placing himself under scrutiny of this guy. So account of us. Praise the Lord. Amen. That a man be found faithful. Praise the Lord. A man be found. He did not remove himself from the equation because he knew he is a custodian of something that has been entrusted to him by God. And those are the mysteries of God. The gospel of Christ. He was being accountable. accountable. Let a man so account of us. Hallelujah. And what does it mean to be faithful? Amen. As the Amplified Version puts it, I like this translation, it means proving yourself worthy of trust. Proving yourself worthy of trust. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And it's so peaceful when you're dealing with someone, you know, we are talking patia, you know, 10,000. It will bring the change. As in, you're so sure, you're not wondering, Lord, no, you're not called, you're not sure whether they'll pick the phone or not. Amen. It's so stressful to deal with people who are not faithful. Proverbs says, a faithful man who can find. Eh? A faithful man who can find. So, someone is faithful means someone is worthy of trust. Worthy of trust. Someone proving yourself worthy of trust. Can you prove yourself worthy of trust when it comes to money? Amen. When it comes to money. I think someone mentioned this a long time I had, that if you cannot be trusted with money, you cannot be trusted. Okay? If you cannot trust someone with money, you cannot be trusted. Praise the Lord. Then remember, we are in the kingdom. Amen. We are in the kingdom, and there's no way you can separate the kingdom from finances or the kingdom from money. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Actually, looking at the Gospels, Jesus spoke more of money than anything else. Praise the Lord. He spoke more of money and the kingdom. So we cannot separate this to the kingdom and money. Glory to God. Glory to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know this scripture very well. Ecclesiastes chapter 10, verse 19. Can we all turn there together? Bible says, a feast is made for laughter, and wine maketh merry, but money answereth all things. Praise the Lord. The things is not in the original Hebrew, so it means, but money answereth all. Amen. Hallelujah. But when you put the word things, it makes more sense. And money answereth all things. Money answereth all things. So the kingdom and money, you cannot separate them. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And when we love the scripture that says, for his sake he died poor so that he may become rich, right? So that he may become rich. The word rich means rich. Amen. Let's not try to spiritualize it or quote it. It just means the way rich is rich. Amen. Rich is, you can't talk of rich without the equation of money there. Hallelujah. And in case you're someone is confused of, did really God say we need to be rich? Hello? The Bible says, in Matthew chapter 5 verse 3, the Bible says, blessed are the poor in what? In spirit. Not poor physically. Okay? Not poor physically. So, it's God. The man of God, I found in the faith, Bishop Oyedepo said, I think he was abroad at that time, and then the Lord spoke to him. He said, go home and make my people rich. Praise the Lord. Go home. Where? Africa. And make my people rich. Praise the Lord. So, it is even in the heart of God for his people to prosper. Praise the Lord. The Bible says he takes pleasure. Let's open Psalm 35. Hallelujah. Pleasure. He enjoys. It gives him pleasure. It gives him joy to see. understanding, amen? He takes pleasure in the prosperity of his servants. Glory to God. So he's concerned. How are we doing? How are we doing? I remember Job 36:11, the Bible says, if you obey a servant, you shall spend your days in pleasure. Hallelujah. And what? Praise the Lord. You shall spend your days in pleasure and prosperity. Praise the Lord. So prosperity, and you're not talking prosperity without finances. Finances must be in that equation. Praise the Lord. And then how can we now employ this or enforce this particular aspect? I think Jesus made it very clear in Matthew chapter 6, verse 33. He says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. Praise the Lord. So remember the kingdom, and say the kingdom and money, you can't separate these two. Say, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And remember the kingdom is inside you. Amen. The kingdom is inside us. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And all these things shall be added. Shall be added unto you. So when you're seeking the Lord, when you're serving the Lord, you're serving the purposes of the kingdom. You are after the expansion of the kingdom. Amen. You are after souls being born again. You are after beautifying the house of God, ministering. Remember, the Bible says, we had the anchor scripture, should be last month, in Hebrews chapter 6, verse 10, that the Lord is not unjust to forget thy labor of love, which you always minister. You know, it's a labor. Service is labor. Praise the Lord. Service is labor. When it comes to finances, you labor in finances. Amen. Praise the Lord. God is not unjust to forget that. So when you say seek ye first, the word seek here means prioritize. Prioritize the kingdom of God. Seek ye first. Give it priority. Amen. And all these things shall be added. All these things shall be added. As in, and even money, praise the Lord, is part and parcel of the kingdom. It's part and parcel of the kingdom. It's what shall be also added unto us. Now think about this, I thought someone can give you a field. Say, okay, take that field. Or even you can buy a field. Okay? You've been given a field. So what you do with that field, it's yours. You own it. Okay? You own it. Like we have the kingdom. What we do with that, or what you get out of it, it's a matter of our responsibility. Remember the attributes you checked on. A matter of a special responsibility, how accountable we'll be, or how faithful we will be. Praise the Lord. Then what you get from that field. So imagine you've been given a field, and then in that field, you can chimba kisima, right? Or you can choose to buy water. Right? Because there's so much land, you can get water anywhere. Believe so. So you can choose to rear chicken. You can choose to plant crops. If you want to buy, it is also your own. You choose. So, but then water is part of that land. The plants are part of that land. The chicken you want to have are part of it. It's you. What will you do to have them? Praise the Lord. But take, remember, there's a story in the book of Proverbs. Talking about the slothful. Amen. We passed to a place where he had made a vineyard. Proverbs 24 verse 30 says, I went by the field of the slothful and by the vineyard of the man void of understanding. Void of understanding. And lo, it was all grown over with thorns and nettles and covered the face thereof, and the stone wall thereof was broken down. Then I saw riches, the wealth, the blessings are part of the kingdom. Amen. If you're prioritizing the kingdom, then they shall be added unto you. So you have the kingdom. What can you do with it? Praise the Lord. What can you do with it? And then you have the money. God has blessed you with finances. What can you do with it? Praise the Lord. Even before you, what you do with it, what will you do to have it? Praise the Lord. What will you do to have that finance? Amen. Because it will be told a little sleep, a little slumber. As in poverty here is a choice. You chose poverty because of your way of life. You chose poverty. And then that's not stewardship. Amen. That's not stewardship. So we are going to check on how the serving God, like serving God and hearing the word of God all over about finances and what have I learned. So far, what have I learned? And also based on the word of God, what have we learned and even being under this ministry? Praise the Lord. Amen. So one principle that I've learned is the principle of sowing. Praise the Lord. Is a principle of sowing, and I encourage you, please get last Sunday's message, and you get more light on this subject, more light. Last Sunday from God's servant in the house, and it will truly bless you. Amen. So the principle of sowing, and we will go back to the aspect of the kingdom. Amen. Of the kingdom from Matthew chapter 13. Matthew chapter 13. Here, this verse is like we have like almost three parables in this one chapter talking about money. Matthew chapter 13, from verse 31. It says that the parable put he forth and then saying, the kingdom of heaven is like a grain of mustard seed, which a man took and sowed in the field. A mustard seed is the smallest seed, which a man took and sowed in the field. Okay? Which indeed is the least of all seeds, is the least of all seeds, but when it is grown, hallelujah, it is the greatest among herbs and becometh a tree, so that the birds of the air come and lodge in the branches there. Hallelujah. The man sowed this seed, which a man took and sowed. The kingdom of heaven is like a grain of mustard seed, which a man took and sowed in the field. So, whatever he got was from his sowing. And number one, what I've learned is that what you have in your hand, praise the Lord, what you have in your I mean, it has a lot of potential. So if you despise something and say, okay, so what is this? This is too small. And maybe that's what you have at that time. This is too small. If I give, what will happen to me? You know, if I give it, what will happen to me? But in this kingdom, we are talking about this kingdom, how things are operating here. In this kingdom, things, it's that small, that master thing. Now, whatever is in your hand that you think this is a master thing. If you sow it in faith, it will bring forth. The Bible says, the tree, it is the greatest among herbs. When it is sown, it has to be sown. Praise the Lord. It has to be sown. The very good example is the widow of Zarephath. Amen. He had only very little for himself. The last meal they had for that season, they were to eat and die. Praise the Lord. But when the man of God came, he came with a sowing mentality. Give to me first. Amen. Give to me first. Give to me first. So someone, God may be telling you, give to me first. What is it that you have? You think is too small? Whatever cannot meet your needs. If it cannot meet your needs at that time, sow it. Praise the Lord. That is your master seed. Sow it. Hallelujah. Sow it. It will bring forth a harvest. It will bring forth a harvest. Praise the Lord. Glory to God. That's the power of sowing. Amen. Seed is to sow. Praise the Lord. And remember, 2 Corinthians, the Bible says, the Lord giveth seed to the sower. Mm. Hallelujah. He gives seed to the sower. If you are a gives seed to the sower. Hallelujah. So if you are a sower, you always have seed. Amen. So don't say you don't have anything. You have seed. You have seed to sow. Praise the Lord. And I remember sometimes offerings will be asked for, maybe for something, for either the project in church. But whatever I have, you know, remember, I thank God. The first after campus, I was home, and then a friend of mine got me this job in the government offices. Not really at a place by the government, but I was there just helping some administration work. And the amount I was getting, that was, praise the Lord, I was getting 2,000 a month. 2,000. And transport, where I come from, transport those days, the bondas were not so frequent. What was there was some Probox, see Probox and such, but that's how I can call it. And then you could squeeze there, and you know you are paying 50. So if you're getting 2,000, you're paying 50 every day to and fro, that's 100 more. How much do you have? As in, see, what do you really have? Okay, so we were used to walking, so okay, for us it's not an issue. So we could walk for, it was 1 hour home, to and fro, 1 hour back. It was a normal thing. I know this should not scare anyone. It was a very normal thing, so we were used to this since growing up. So, but I was getting this, and I was so excited that the first time I'm getting a salary, or someone is giving me, actually you are being paid, I think, per week. So every week you're getting 500. Okay? And I was taught in church about typing and all that. And I was so happy that I could type. As in, I was just happy I have money to type. And if there's something that's required in church or even a project, I just have a company in my ability. You know, I was so happy that I can even pledge 200 to give up. For me, it was a lot. I don't know. Praise the Lord. And that was my seed. That was the seed God was giving me. Give a seed to the sower. Praise the Lord. Because my heart, I was so happy. I was going to sow. So, for me, it was my seed. Praise the Lord. And I thank God. I thank God. Though your beginning is small, the Bible says your latter end shall be greatly increased. Praise the Lord. Shall be greatly increased. So, don't look at what you have. Praise the Lord. With that 10,000, someone says, divine tithe. How will I eat? How will I pay my rent? You know, how will I, how about transport? Praise the Lord. How about transport? Praise the Lord. If you're a sower, that will not even come to your head. Amen? If you're truly a servant, praise the Lord, a steward, you know this is what God has given me. Praise the Lord. This is what God has given me. So what is my responsibility to eat? Praise the Lord. And then the principle of sowing is very clear in the book of Genesis chapter 1 verse 11. Genesis chapter 1 verse 11. Hallelujah. And God said, let the earth bring forth grass, the herb yielding seed, and the fruit tree yielding fruit after his kind. Whose seed is in itself upon the earth, and it was so. So God created everything with that seed. Praise the Lord. That was the secret of its multiplication. So that we wouldn't go back and say, okay, trees, leaves, and men. They are burned everywhere. The forest is burned. Okay, so let me start creation again. No, he wasn't going to go back to creation. No, he finished and rested. But he put the seed in those plants. He put the seed in the animals. Put the seed in the human beings. Praise the Lord. To be able to reproduce. And a seed is sown. A seed has to be sown. Praise the Lord. That is the secret of what? Multiplication. Hallelujah. The secret of multiplication. And remember Genesis chapter 1 verse 28. We love this scripture. The Bible said, and God blessed them. And God said unto them, be fruitful, multiply, and replenish the earth. How are two people going to replenish the earth? It's the principle of the seed. Praise the Lord. That was the principle of the seed. How are they to? How? Praise the Lord. And you are told we are the seed of Abraham. So, replenish the earth and subdue it and have dominion over the sea and the fish of the sea, over the fowl of the land, over every living thing that moveth upon sowing? How are we going to replenish without sowing? Amen. The Bible says, like, I remember Mass Guru saying, like, God gave us a tree. Amen. But He put furniture in that tree. He put what? Furniture is all manner. Beds. What else is meant for tree? Pepper. It is in that tree. Praise the Lord. But then you remember, that man who was void of understanding didn't know what to do with that thing. So we thank God for the wisdom that He has given unto men, so that we can make even this Bible from tree. Amen. From tree. The paper that you have, from tree. Hallelujah. The seat that you're sitting on, from tree. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. I hope we are understanding. Amen. Hallelujah. So there's no way we can multiply, we can replenish without sowing. Glory to God. So the seed in your hand, don't say, this is not, what is this? Amen. This is for you. It's for you to begin determining your end. Though your beginning is small, though your seed is small now, glory to God. Your latter end, you shall not be giving that 10-fold. It's not that 50-fold will be given forever. Praise the Lord. Start giving it now. Amen. And the principle of God is start where you are. Glory to God. God knows you. Start where you are. Praise the Lord. Not according to what a man doesn't have. According to what a man has. Praise the Lord. That's what you give to the Lord. That's what you give to the Lord. Amen. And the power of the seed that you get the message, it will greatly bless you for last Sunday. Another principle learned where in serving, in service, is the principle of investing. Amen. In this ministry, you know, Father, that is his, I don't know, is my mandate or something. The principle of investing. I think until we got connected here, we always knew that, I'd say maybe most of it because of our ignorance, but it's how much you save, that's how you increase. That's never so. Amen. That's never so. We told us about investing. And what is investing? Investing, that is the power. Investing is the power to create wealth. It's the power to create wealth. Amen. Okay, Matthew 13. Remember our scripture, Matthew chapter 13. Praise the Lord. And therefore, for whatever you're having right now, the monies that you're getting right now, amen. Because and he sold all that he had. So he had something. He had something that was enough to give him that thing that he was looking for. He had something that was enough to give him that treasure, that those cars. And 46, who when he had found one car of great price. Hallelujah. So investors are not afraid. Who just hear in the near of some figures and you're like, how will I get there? How will I get that money? Amen. They are not afraid of great price. Went and sold all that he had. He sold it. All that he had. To do what? To buy. What is investing? That is the power to purchase. It gives you the power to purchase. Praise the Lord. Investing gives you power to purchase. He sold all that he had. Whether it is his saving, he went and took them to get something better than what he had. Praise the Lord. Which is of a great price. Hallelujah. Number one, from this parable we're learning, you can only multiply by investing, not by saving. So as long as he was holding to what he had, there's no way he could have gotten this treasure. Amen? And definitely, if you read the stories of treasure highland, treasure something, amen. You know that there's something precious. When they show you in cartoons, you see when they open the treasure box, you see shiny stones and pearls and all that. You know, something that if you go and sell it, wherever, as in when you're not a Kiona, that is the end of their working, as in this, with this. I know it can feed my generation because of the cost of that treasure. Praise the Lord. Because of the cost of that treasure. So you can see. So he decided, okay, this is so costly. Let me just leave what I have. I mean, let me just eat from what I have, what I have gathered. That will be all. We're not even believing this in the scriptures. Praise the Lord. So you cannot even multiply by investing and not saving. Amen. God's servant is not afraid to invest. Amen. If you're afraid to invest, because you're thinking this is something costly. Okay. For me, I come with this mentality of you need to save. And then there's one day, in my notebook, there was 1,000 notes inside there. Couldn't make a to Apple, as in I did not use it, and I didn't see the need to use it at that time. So you put in a car, I used that notebook very frequently, but then the 1,000 notes was in the past, in the last page. So it was still there. 1 month is still there. 2 months is still there. Then later, I said, by the way, if I put this money somewhere, you know, it is the same value. 2 months ago, it was 1,000. 10 months from today, it will still be 1,000 in my notebook. For me, I'll be Nadika Patio. Praise the Lord. And it won't increase in value. Praise the Lord. So, and I've realized investing is not for the fearful hearted. No. Praise the Lord. That those who take risks, you take steps, praise the Lord, to get that treasure in that field. Glory to God. You saw a treasure in the field of the technology. Amen. You saw a treasure in the field of construction. Praise the Lord. So, thank God. God has given you something. God has given you some. All this you've been working 5 to 8. There's something you're getting. Amen. It is a seed for you. It's a platform for you to go and invest. Praise the Lord. It's a platform for us to invest. Amen. Amen. And you can see people, I think the only people you're waiting for those who are working, you're waiting for NSSF. So you are at what age? You're to be on that and get that. I was wondering, which kind of life is this, honestly? Like, if you have been a casting for years, let's say 40 years, you've been working for the government. And after that, you're there looking like a beggar. It's like life ends for some people. Things change. But then people even die faster. Because there's nothing to do. There's nothing to do. They have not invested in anything to give them money or to give them income. You're waiting. one way. Praise the Lord. It is not. It is not. It is all over the scriptures. If we care to learn, we should learn and do something. Praise the Lord. So don't be afraid. Don't be afraid to invest to get more than what you have. Because actually what the Bible is telling us, there is more than what you have right now. And that is the truth. There is more than what you are having right now. There is more. And it is out there. It is in the field. Replenish, multiply, we have. Hallelujah. There is more than what you have. Praise the Lord. Proverbs 11:25. The liberal soul will be made fat. Amen. The liberal soul. Liberal soul. So in this kingdom, it's not about what I keep. It's about what I give. Amen. It's not about what I'm keeping. It's about what I give. Remember the parable of the talents? Matthew 25 verse 20. If you want to rear chicken, you know, you have something has to leave you for you to get something. Something must leave you for you to get something. Matthew 25, you know that scripture very well about the talents. Investing gives you power to purchase. Oh, praise the Lord. Power to purchase. Hallelujah. Verse 20, Bible says,
lost. Praise the Lord. That nothing be lost.
everything God has given us, we have the responsibility to use it wisely. We have the responsibility to use our money wisely. Praise the Lord. Use your money wisely. Don't just spend because you have. Don't just spend because you have. Okay? Don't just spend because you have. Isaiah 65 verse 8.
Thank you for everyone that has been watching, tuning with us.